Otago University says it's time for grief, not action, following the death of a student at a Dunedin flat party. 19-year-old Sophia Crestani died when hundreds of people crammed into the Dundas Street house and then tried to leave. Students told our Otago Southland reporter Tess Brunton they want more security in the wake of the tragedy.
Motorists slow down as they approach the flat and the growing wall of flowers left in tribute. A Dundas Street resident, who wants to remain anonymous, says emotions are still raw for many students.
People are definitely thinking about what changes might happen next year to prevent such an accident happening again. Having someone get into an accident like that just makes everyone feel a little bit more cautious and wary, I suppose, of situations like that.
University of Otago Vice-Chancellor Harlene Haynes says additional support is on the ground to help grieving students. She says the two who were seriously injured during the party are now fine.
As a parent myself, I am sure that there are a lot of parents who are concerned about what's happened here. I understand that. This is a tragic accident. What I can say is that in the wake of a tragic accident, this university community has come together in a way that I just cannot believe.
With exam season looming, Ms. Haynes says students will be able to apply for compassionate consideration if they need additional support. Harlene Haynes didn't rule out increasing campus watch security or finding ways to improve student safety, but says for now the focus is on helping students grieve.
Right now it's far too early to say what's going to happen going forward. As you know, that there's a police investigation, but in the days and weeks to come, the university will be working with the family, with police, with OUSA, to think about whether or not there are ways that we can make this community even safer.
An Otago University chaplain has carried out a blessing at the Dundas Street flat. But the manor residents have no plans to return. Ms. Haynes says the university is helping to find them new accommodation. Otago University Students Association President James Heath says he hopes students will embrace the support available.
We urge our students to be there for each other. Reach out to your friends and flatmates. Talk, listen, and show the strength of our community. Now is not the time to be pointing fingers or blame. Now was the time to be supporting our community.
Sophia Crestani was a pupil at Wellington's Queen Margaret College from 2013 to 2017. The principal, Jane Anne Young, says the school and its current and former students are devastated by her death. She says they have set up an area for students to gather to remember Sophia and to write messages which will be passed on to her family.
It's such a devastating and unusual situation that we find ourselves in, and Sophia was very close to her friends. We already have a significant number of girls who have returned to the school just to be in a safe place where they knew her very well, and we're delighted to be able to make that available to them.
Mrs. Young says Sophia is remembered as an incredibly talented design student.
She actually had a dress that was displayed at the National Museum, which was one of the most beautiful garments that I've ever seen created by a student. For many of us, that's the first place that we went to, and just looking back on her time at school, I'm just seeing how many things that she was involved in, whether it was basketball, dragon boating, and her creativity areas, and she was just a great kid.
The school's head of senior school and the chaplain, who Mrs. Young says both knew Sophia well, have gone to Dunedin to support family and friends. A police spokesperson, Will Black, says 30 CIB detectives are working on the case alongside the community and youth team.
Out of something as tragic as this, the police, the university, everyone who's been involved in this incident, you know, we all just want to do the best that we can to ensure that an event like this never happens again.
People who were at the party are being encouraged to speak to the police. In Dunedin for Checkpoint, Cortes Brunton, TNA.